Hi everyone, good Sunday afternoon. Meteorologist Griffin Hardy here with an update on your forecast. As expected, another rainy day out there. Hasn't been rainy all day long. There were some peaks of sunshine that we saw earlier today in Greenville, but clouds have taken back over, as has the rain in many places, especially down towards the southwest of town. You got a cluster of storms rolling through Elberton and Abbeville counties right now. Zooming in a little closer on it on live Super Doppler 4. It's just now moving through Lownsville just after 4:30, soon to be moving through Abbeville and Greenwood here over the next half an hour to an hour. So heads up for folks down there. Going to be another rainy late afternoon and early evening for you. Same for folks in Anderson. Was briefly heavy there in the southern bits of Anderson County, but the that shower itself looks to be fizzling out in large part. Then you got another cluster of showers and storms moving through Spartanburg County right now. Move soon to be moving into Cherokee County. You see here, these downpours aren't really lasting all that well. They briefly flare up with some thunder and lightning, but then they fizzle back out pretty quickly as well. So that doesn't mean the rain can be briefly heavy, so be on the lookout for that if you're driving this afternoon, this evening. Same for folks over to the east of Greenville between Wade Hampton Boulevard and I-85. You got some downpours rolling through Taylor's and Greer right now, as well as one little shower up towards northern Greenville County that is also in the process of fizzling out. Again, these short-lived downpours living up to their name. As well as Madison County up into western North Carolina, you got some downpours happening here north of Asheville, but luckily nothing really severe at this point. I'm not really seeing much of any potential for severe weather. That can always change in the summertime, but at least for now, things look to be pretty quiet. But there is still more rain to get through, a lot of heavy rain down towards south and central Georgia. And that chance for more of it will be there for the rest of the evening tonight. So hang on to the umbrella. You're going to need it for probably the rest of the evening and probably into early tomorrow morning. It's possible we get some storms late tonight, even after 10 o'clock, especially over towards Cherokee County. It looks like the Future Radar really wants to paint some more heavy downpours and thunderstorms over that way. And again, even as late as 1 a.m. into tonight, still a possible possibility that we get to see some more heavy downpours on the way. Into tomorrow morning, still some lingering stuff in the mountains. But by 8 to 9 o'clock in the morning, we see things quiet down and see cloudy skies and just more humidity. And that's going to be the story for tomorrow again as well. When the atmosphere is this humid outside, you're going to get showers and storms. And that'll be the story for Monday as well. Rain chances still very high at around 70 to 80%. That being said, as you just saw, it's not going to be a complete washout. There will still be some dry times, but the chance of seeing at least some rain during the day is pretty good at around, again, 70 to 80%. That goes for Tuesday as well. Pattern not really going to be changing all that much for the next 3 to 4 days as the deep tropical moisture remains in place. Like we explained yesterday, winds are out of the southwest, and that means that you're getting a lot of moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, and that pattern looks to hold for Wednesday as well as Thursday, with chances of rain still very high. Showers and storms are not going to be going away for a while until we get most likely to late Friday and early Saturday morning. That is when we get a bit of a pattern shift, as well as some drier air that comes in for the start of next weekend. So I expect the rain chances to start going back down by the time you get to Saturday and Sunday into next weekend. But in the meantime, there will be a lot more of this coming on the way. Over the next 5 days, it'll be more just a lot of rain and pretty good coverage of it, somewhere in the ballpark of around 2 to 3 inches in total. The local amounts will probably vary, as they often do, but there's a very good chance that we'll get another solid soaking over the next 5 days. So plan ahead for that. Tropical disturbances, still nothing to speak of here. Saharan dust very much in control, not just in the Caribbean, but across the eastern Atlantic as well. Another outbreak of dust coming across the Atlantic. So we do not expect any tropical activity for the next couple of days. You often see this in late July, these big outbreaks of dust coming across the Atlantic. So that is at least putting a lid on any possible tropical activity for the next few days. Mid to upper 60s for lows tomorrow morning across the mountains, low 70s to upper 60s in northeast Georgia and the upstate. And the trade-off with all these showers and storms is, yeah, it's really humid outside, but that means that the heat, the highs in the low to mid 90s, even the upper 90s that we saw past week and a half, those aren't going to be there for this week. We're going to see highs in the mid to upper 80s, which is really not bad for late July. Here's what I've got for the 4-day impact days, these next 4 days, just because of how high the rain chances are. And again, I have the sun behind the storm icons because it's not going to be a total washout. This is the chance of rain, of seeing at least some rain during some part of the day. So 70 to 80%, take that into consideration, that there will be some dry times, but there is a very good chance of getting at least some rain for the next next 5 days. And then Saturday and Sunday, that's when it starts to backpedal a little bit. Looks like we'll get some drier air then. But in the meantime, it's not going to be too hot. Highs in the mid to upper 80s the next week. No 90s in sight for the upcoming week. Same for the 4-day plus for the mountains. Lots of good rain chances on the way, but certainly no 90s in sight. Low 80s for the next few days. Upper 70s on Friday, and keeping with the low 80s and lower rain chances for next weekend.